Hello everyone, this is Mark David Heiser, also you may know me as Day Did You Win, and I am doing my race review of the Monumental Marathon held in Indianapolis on November 3rd, 2018. Doing this this differently, usually I write my blog reviews, but today I'm going to try the video, see how this goes, see what you guys think. Leave your comments either on YouTube or on my blog or social media, let me know what you think, and we'll see where we go from here. But I actually prefer talking rather than typing. So, Monumental Marathon, as I said, held in downtown Indianapolis. This was the 11th annual. It has become, quite honestly, my favorite marathon, at least one that I can afford to do every year. Obviously, Boston still ranks up there at number one. But Monumental is the one marathon that I must do every year. So many reasons for that. The course is beautiful. This year, with the fall leaves turning late like they did, it made for a very beautiful course running along mainly northern Indianapolis and so forth. So it's also a very flat, very fast course as well. So if you're looking for a PR, you're in the Midwest, you're looking for a good Indiana run, this is the one for you. Also, the city of Indianapolis really rolls out the red carpet for runners. They love, Indianapolis loves bringing in big events. You know, when they held the Super Bowl a few years back, they've held numerous Final Fours there for men's and women's basketball. Big Ten Championships, the NCAA, well, not NCAA, but College Football National Championship will be held there here in a couple of years. Indianapolis does big events very well, and obviously they hold Indianapolis 500 every year, so they know what they're doing and they know how to treat their guests. Even though that there are a couple other events going on in Indianapolis, you felt very well welcomed there. So we got to Indianapolis. Oh, and one other thing I like about Indianapolis and how they do their races, there are hotels right in downtown. There are at least, gosh, 5, 6, 7, 8 within a very short walking distance of the start-finish line. For instance, this year, our hotel was right at the finish line. And so I didn't decide not to check a bag at gear check because I could just walk into the hotel, walk out of the hotel, and go right to the start and come right from the finish line. Don't have to worry about it. So I bypassed that for the first time this year, and that was a great advantage, having a hotel right in downtown. Also didn't have to worry about parking that day. I heard a couple people say that they had issues with parking. We'll get into that here in a little bit on race day. And, they're like, yeah, from now on, we're going to get a hotel in downtown. It's just a lot easier to do that. All right. So, Expo started Thursday and, also all day on Friday. You had to pick up your gear or your bib number at the Expo. You could not do race day packet pickup. So what you got with that was a couple things. You got your, first of all, obviously you get your race shirt. This is this year's race shirt, 2018. You got the logo right there on the front, which is nice. Also on the sleeves, you see this little design. This actually is a representation basically of the Indiana state flag. Or not Indiana state flag, I'm sorry, the Indianapolis flag. I do know what my state flag looks like. This is the city flag of Indianapolis. So that is pretty cool. They incorporate that on the sleeve, but as I said, there's the logo on the front, some sponsors on the back, not too overly crowded, but there are some. Yeah, you gotta put the sponsors on there. They pay good money to help put on these events, so I don't blame them. The shirt was made by a company. Actually, it's not the same company as usual. I'm not sure who it is anymore. So, but it used to be, Atlantic, I believe is what it's called. I'm not sure why they went away from that company. I really like their shirts, but this is still a great, great shirt. Also, you get a race weekend guide in your book or in your packet. I'll be showing you this race weekend guide here in a second for one other purpose. Also, for those who are coming, this is really for a lot of people who are coming to support you. This is called the Fan Pass. And what's so great about this, you get a detailed map of the course, which I have it upside down right now. And it shows you where you can go and see your runners as they're going along the course and whatnot. Also gives the runners an idea of where aid stations are and so forth. It does also give you, especially if you're following the course by bike, if you're a fan, shows you some good places where you can stop on your bike. and that sort of thing. So the weather, let's talk about the race a little bit. The weather on Sunday, or Saturday, my word, was about as perfect as you can get. It was in, temperatures were in the mid upper 30s at the start. And there was really hardly any wind to speak of. So the temperatures for this day, the weather, fantastic. It was sunny. Couldn't ask for much better. I made a race time decision to go with the arm sleeves. I'm kind of regretting that I did that, but I did keep with the singlet, the shorts, compression socks, and also a visor and sunglasses, and also my Trex Air headphones. So that was basically what I ran with. Oh, and my Orange Mud Hydro Quiver, since I don't do well with Gatorade, at least the traditional Gatorade. And so the race for me didn't go as well as I had hoped. My goal was to start off with a 135 and 140 half. I did, I'm going to bring up my splits here real quick. I did go out just a tad fast. I was staying right behind a 135 pacer, and he seemed to have been running about 35, 40 seconds fast for the first part of the for the first half of the race. And I can't say that really is what hurt me. Yeah, 134.45 is what I came across, and the pacer was still a good 35, probably 45 seconds ahead of me. So he's probably a minute fast. So you just really can't trust the pacers, obviously. I mean, they're there to help you. I get that. But sometimes it just doesn't work out. So anyways, I did come across a 134.45, not exactly, you know, too fast, but I did run a couple faster miles than I should have. Probably in there that led to that. I was well on pace to run probably about under a 134 earlier, and I backed off towards the end of the first half. Second half, I just struggled. This is my third marathon this fall. All of them under 320. This was the one I was really focusing on, and I probably should have just kept it to ran my late or my mid-September marathon, not done Fort for Fitness and late September, and just focused on Monty Mel being my key race. But that's hindsight being 2020. Would have been a great idea. But really, once again, the crowd support on this on along the course was great. Aid stations were great, well manned. I didn't take aid at every station, but when I did, I didn't have any issue getting my water. They did have a couple gel stops along the way for those of you who like goo. That was the gel that they had on hand. As I said earlier, they had Gatorade at all the aid stations. It was more of a traditional Gatorade, not the Gatorade Endurance that I like. And so that's why I carried my own. And really, like I said, support was great. Indianapolis police officers out there every intersection, making sure we were protected. Fewer complaints from people about the road closures than normal. Also, probably something went into that. President Trump was in town, so happened Friday night and Saturday morning, and so that closed even more roads, and I think more people understood what was going on more with that and expected the roads to be closed. So a lot less complaining, a lot less cars honking at police officers trying to get us to move and that sort of thing. So anyways, all that to say, the city did a great job with everything that was thrown in to that. Usually, obviously, the president's not here during that time, so they did a great job of handling that situation. Once you cross the finish line, you're given a couple things. One, of course, is your finisher's medal. Here is this year's medal. Now, you'll notice that there's a little notch missing from it. This is the fifth year in a row they've done it this way. And the reason being is they just got done with a four-year series of medals. Once again, if you think back to the shirt, the sleeve on the shirt looked like the state or the city flag. It is Indianapolis city flag, it's not the state flag. And so it looks like this when the series is completed. This is mine from last year. As you can see, it started in 2014, 15, 16, and 17. Once you finished it, you got the circle star, the circle with the star on it to complete your medal series. So that was a really cool idea, I thought, when they came out with it. The issue was, apparently people got mad when they came in 2015 and 2016 and 2017 saying, wait a second, I got this oddly shaped medal with a piece knocked out of it that I can't complete my medal series. I wish I would have known about this sooner. And they did announce it right away in 2014 that it was coming. I wish they would have just stuck with ending the series in 2017, but they I guess had enough complaints about it, and so they said, okay, we're going to continue it, but they made it a little different. There is an eye in here, and so they made it so also so it's going to be more of a horizontal case. They have a horizontal case option now to where when you run four of these in a row now, starting this year, 2018, it's going to spell out Indy. So I-N-D-Y. And another complaint they had, and I just don't care about this, was in order for it to get in this case last year, you had to cut the ribbons off your medals. Obviously, as you can see, I cut my ribbons off. I still have them, but I cut them off. And so this year with the vertical or with the horizontal case, you're going to be able to keep the ribbons on, I guess. But honestly, with the notches missing and all that, I probably am not going to get the horizontal case. If anything, I might get the square case again, complete my series that way again. I don't know. I get what they're saying by trying to make people happy by letting them complete their first medal series. But I wish they would have just made this just a square and do the horizontal case that way. I think that would look a lot better than having these obnoxious notches missing on a horizontal thing. But anyways, so that's the medal this year. I think it looks really cool. Now, I said I was going to come back to the cover of the weekend guide. This is the Indiana War Memorial. And this statue right here is what is represented on the medal. So back in 2014, when this series started, when the first series started, the Indiana War Memorial was the first medal, as you can see. So my guess is they're going to take pieces of these monuments for following years and do those. So you got that. This is the state capitol, and that's the Circle Sailors Monument. All right, and so the other thing they give you when you finish, besides your food, obviously, they do give you water, banana, cookie, chips, and you can later on get a slice of pizza as well, is they give you a nice hat, which is great. They give you, of course, a space blanket as well, but the hat is great just to be able to throw on your head. Temperatures were not bad at the end of the race, probably mid-40s, but it's just nice to be able to throw a hat on you right away, a dry hat. That way you're able to just keep your body temperature, you know, good, and so it doesn't just plummet. One other thing here is the half marathon medal. This is my wife's medal. She ran the half on Saturday. As you can see, identical except for in color and the color of ribbon as well. She got, my medal is gold. Hers is a silver color. And so it's nice that a race like this, while they want to be able to allow you to use the race series, no matter what races you run in the 4 years, that they still have distinct differences, such as color and the color of ribbon. So it is easy to tell. Now, one other thing that I got at the race on Saturday was they did a thing called the Indy-thon. They've done this now for a few years. Basically, it's where you run the Indy half, which is in October, mid-October, and you run monumental marathon or half marathon or 5K in the monumental marathon series. So I got this medal for completing the Indy-thon, and each medal comes with a charm here, I guess is the best way of putting it. And so mine says ultra because I did the Indy half and I did the monumental full marathon. Now my wife, she got this as well, but hers says full because she did the monumental half marathon and the Indy fall half marathon. And so she ran the total of a full marathon distance. You can also do a 5K half marathon combination. I'm sure you could do 5K marathon combination. I'm not sure what they would call that. Or you could do 5K and 5K. And I'm sure that says 10K probably. But I'm not sure. Didn't really look into it that much. I just knew what I was getting, knew what my wife was getting. So that was it. Other than that, like I said, this is a great fall race. This is a great way to end the year. It is a great goal race because the flat course, as I said earlier, is flat and fast. Obviously, you know, weather can play a factor. However, this is where I hold my PR, and I did it with 40 mile per hour winds on that on race day. And so no matter what the weather conditions, this course always seems to be fast. It is one of the top 20 as far as size marathons in the United States. And they do sell out every year. Now they don't sell out right away. They usually sell out 2-3 weeks in advance. So you do have some time, but be watching out. If this is a race that you want to run, be watching out New Year's Day. They always have a huge discount. It's like $60 or $65 registration for the first 1,000 people who register. So be on the lookout for that. You want to take advantage of that. I will be signing up at midnight on January 1st, 12:01. I will be on my computer or on my phone registering for the 2019 Money Mill Marathon. I will be going back for my 7th next year, and I really hope to see some of you there. Like I said, beautiful day, beautiful course. You will love it. Downtown Indianapolis does things right. You get into town night before the race. You don't move your car until you're ready to go home. Everything is that accessible in town. There's pasta restaurants. There's all kinds of stuff to do in downtown Indy that you will want to check out. Maybe even the Pacers will be home and you can catch a game the night before. So with an 8 o'clock race, 8 a.m. race, you'll have time to do some stuff at night. So if you have any questions, like I said, this is the first time I'm doing a race review by video. Let me know what you think, and we'll see how this goes, and we'll see if we continue it or if I just go back to the blog. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I will talk to you guys later. Have a good day.